Hello everyone, this is Sharda from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. I welcome you all to my video lecture on the topic Artificial Intelligence. In today's session, we are going to learn about information retrieval. As we know, information is nothing but a collection of huge data. Retrieval means fetching information that the user desires from the huge collection. The term information retrieval was coined by Calvin Movers in the year 1951. The formal definition of information retrieval goes like this. So, information retrieval is finding material, usually documents, of an unstructured nature. So, here we are focusing only on the text retrieval systems, and the term unstructured means a data which does not have a clear semantic structure. The data which is structured is nothing but a data which is stored in the form of tables. Here, from unstructured data, we have to fetch the relevant information which the user desires. To do this process, we require a system or a software program that facilitates user for finding their needs. This particular software program is referred to as information retrieval system. So, whenever an information is sought by the user, it should be fetched in a fast and an efficient manner. So, information retrieval aims at modeling, designing, and implementing systems that are able to provide fast and effective content-based access to a large amount of information. Let's look into the difference between information retrieval and the data retrieval. The data retrieval focuses on the data that are stored on a database. So, we will be storing data in the form of records on a table in a database. So, to do any process on a table, we require a querying language, preferably SQL. So, when we query using SQL, the result of the query will be 100% accurate. So, in information retrieval, we do not use any queries, we do not use any querying language. So, the answer or the result of the query will not be 100% accurate. So, this is the difference between information retrieval and the database retrieval. There are few steps for information retrieval. One is identification of relevant documents, ranking of the found documents. We need an architecture to retrieve data. The components required for building an architecture are indexing, which consists of tokenization, stop words removal, stemming, index data structure, query parser, matching, and ranking. So, with these components, we have to build an information retrieval system. We will see each component in detail now. The first process is indexing. As we all know, indexing is nothing but arrangement of data in any particular order such that the data can be easily searched and retrieved. So, it is a pre-process that manages documents in a collection. We will be representing huge data in a term called as corpus. So, once a query is given by the user, indexing should be done such that the corpus and the given query should be matched. This indexing can be implemented using inverted file. It is a data structure for storing indexed information. It will be containing a set of keywords along with the links to the document in which each word appears. Let us look at the basic indexing pipeline over here. So, we have a document that contains inputs as friends, Romans, and countrymen. This input is now passed on to the tokenizer. The tokenizer will split the input into small individual units called as tokens. This splitting will be done by removing all the punctuation marks such as comma, semicolon, hyphenation, apostrophe, etc. So, from the input statement, the tokens such as friends, Romans, countrymen are fetched now. Each individual token will be now passed on to the next stage called as linguistic models. Linguistic model will be giving you the normalized tokens. For example, the token friends will be normalized to friend, Romans will be normalized to Roman, countrymen will be normalized to countryman. Now, this particular normalized tokens will be given to as the input to the indexer. So, to process or to index these tokens, we need an inverted index. So, we'll come to know about the inverted index in the further slides. So, what is the basic idea behind inverted index? So, we will be maintaining a dictionary of terms. Dictionary of terms. Terms here refer to as words. So, we will be having a collection of words which will be named as dictionary or vocabulary or lexicon. Then for each term, we will be maintaining a list that records the occurrence of these terms in any document. This particular listing is termed as posting. Let us now look into an example for an inverted index. To explain this inverted index, I have taken different documents under Shakespeare's plays. Antony and Cleopatra is a separate document. Julius Caesar is a separate document. The Tempest, Hamlet, Othello and Macbeth are different documents. So, the list of terms are listed on the left hand side. The terms are Antony, Brutus, Caesar, Calpurnia, Cleopatra, Mercy and Versa. We have to find the occurrence of each term in these documents. So, all these documents will be identified by an unique identifier called as document ID. This can be done by ourselves by giving the successful integers as the document IDs. For example, Antony and Cleopatra will be given a document ID 1, Julius Caesar will be given a document ID 2, the Tempest will be 3, Hamlet will be 4, Othello will be 5 and Macbeth will be 6, and it goes on like this. The first step is to identify the document using an unique identifier. So, successful integers are used for identifying purposes. Now, we have to develop the inverted index file. It will be looking like this. So, it will be telling us the terms that are present in document, each document. So, if you find Brutus in any of the document, then we'll be marking 1. If the term or the word is not found in any document, that will be marked as 0. So, if we take Brutus, it is found in the file 1, file 2, file 4, file 11 and etc. Similarly, Caesar is found in the document 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 16 and etc. So, this is how an inverted file will look like. It will be consisting of number of terms or a collection of terms called dictionary, along with the occurrences of each term in the document called the posting list. So, how is it stored in memory? We can either store an inverted file in the form of a fixed array like this. So, Brutus will be having a fixed size array, Caesar will be having a fixed size array. So, each term will be having a fixed size array for representing its posting list. So, as we all know, the drawback of fixed array is that if you're trying to add one more detail onto an array in the middle of an element, then the array requires shifting operation. This shifting operation will be costing high. So, this will be the drawback of the fixed array. We do have another drawback. If the array is fixed, there might be a chance of wastage of memory also. So, to overcome this particular drawback, we are going to store this particular inverted file in the form of linked list. I'm going to explain you the storage of inverted file with another example. Let us take two documents. Document 1 with the following sentence. I did enact Julius Caesar. I was killed by the capital. Brutus killed me. So let be with Caesar, the noble Brutus hath told you Caesar was ambitious. This will be the content of document 2. Now, our first step is to find the terms or split the number of words and fill in the document ID. As I've already told you, document ID is nothing but an integer value that is assigned for identification. So the term I is present in the document 1, did and work document 1. Likewise, all the terms should be listed along with the document ID. From so till ambitious, it will be document 2. Now this particular listing will be given or giving or will be sorted according to the alphabetical order. This will be the unique and the most important feature of indexing. So once this particular terms are sorted, that will be fed to the linked list. So if we take ambitious as the first term, the doc frequency is the number of times ambitious is occurring in the document. As you can see, ambitious is a word that is occurring only in the document 2, the doc frequency will become 1. So this will be present in the document 2, so the posting list will be having 2 as the initial linked list. The term CSIR is repeated 3 times in the sentence in the documents, one time in document 1 and 2 times on the document 2. So CSIR, even if it is repeated twice in the document 2, that will be counted as 1. So the frequency will be 1 in document 1 plus 1 in document 2. So the total frequency will be 2. So we will be having the list of postings, the first occurrence in the document 1, which is linked through pointers to the document 2. So this is how we represent the terms along with the posting list in memory. So the second important component of an information retrieval is tokenization. As I've already told you, it is a task of chopping up different words into pieces called as tokens. So what is the main, how will we do tokenization? By ignoring all punctuations. Punctuations will be including comma, colon, apostrophe, hyphenation, white spaces. So whenever all these punctuations are encountered, all these punctuations should be ignored and the individual token should be taken and should be considered. If we consider input as friends, comma Roman, comma countrymen, comma lend me your ears, the individual output of the input will become friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. There are some issues in tokenization. So if we consider a word, Finland's capital, here apostrophe will be an issue. So if you try to remove apostrophe, we'll be having a doubt whether the Finland can be represented by any of the three words, Finland or Finland's or Finland apostrophe is. So here lies a confusion of separating tokens. In the second point, you can find Hewlett Packard, which is a single word which is hyphenated. So if you are trying to remove this hyphenation, we will be ending up with two different tokens. So here comes a doubt to whether consider Hewlett Packard as a single word or two different tokens. I have listed so many words such as state of the art, which is broken up by the help of hyphenated sequence, co-education, lowercase, etc. The third point consists of a noun, which is nothing but San Francisco. So here white space will be acting as the punctuation. So if we remove white space, it will be San filled by Francisco. So we will be having a doubt whether to consider San as a token or Francisco as a token. So these are some issues in tokenization. So we'll not know what are the correct tokens to use in these examples. In addition to the previous issues, tokenization also have some language issues. For example, if we consider a language French, all the tokens that start with an vowel will have an additional letter, a first of five letter, L ensemble. So here this particular tokenization will not work. Similarly, if we consider German as the language, in German, noun compounds will not be segmented. For example, life insurance company employee will be given in a compound sentence as Leben, Persia, Rungs, likewise. So, any sentence that has a compound word will not be segmented in German. So, tokenization or splitting up into tokens will be a difficult task in different languages. So, we'll not be able to form a uniform procedure for tokenization here. We can't have a consistent, unique tokenization procedure here. The next step in information retrieval is stop words removal. As we have come across the most frequent terms like the, a, and, to, be, these words ought to be removed from the document. These words are called as stop words. These words will be filtered out from the list. So, is it necessary to filter stop words? Nowadays, we are dealing with digital documentation where we are having good compression techniques. So, it is not required to filter all these stop words. So, if we consider the phrase like King of Denmark, off here is a stop word. So, if we remove off over there, the King Denmark is a meaningless word here. So, it is not necessary to remove stop words. The next process is stemming. Stemming is nothing but a process of having a single word on behalf of its family of related words. For example, the document will have organize, organizes, and organizing as the words. All these words are representing a only word called organize. Similarly, democracy, democratic, and democratization are all similar words only. So, all these similar words should be stemmed. As I've already told you, the words automate, automatic, automation will be reduced to its equivalent word automat. For example, compressed and compression are both accepted as equivalent to compress. For example, so the compressed version is given shown on the right side. Compress and compress. So stemming is nothing but reducing the words which belongs to the same family or which are conveying the same meaning. These are the main components of information retrieval. The next comes the component called as query processor. Once through the user interface, if a user types a query, that query should also be tokenized. It should stemmed and all the stop words should be removed, so that there will be a perfect matching of queries from the user end and also from the back end. So, exact matching can be done through processing a query. So, once the user query is completely done with all the process, it should be matched with the query that is present on the system, information retrieval system. So, this type of matching or finding the relevant query can be done with various models such as Boolean model, vector space model, and probabilistic model. Once the matching is done successfully, then we have to rank all these documents in decreasing order. There are several ranking algorithms for ranking all our documents. So, if we do web search in Google, we will be able to see the document that is highly cited by so many people in the top rank. So likewise, even in information retrieval system, all the documents should be ranked properly. This is one component, user interface. As we all know, this will be acting as an interface between the user and the system, information retrieval system. The complete architecture looks like this. So let us start with the corpus part. Corpus, as I've already told you, will be representing you a collection of data. So from the large collection, the data should be tokenized, removed, stop word removal, and stemmed in the indexing part, and it should be kept ready in an inverted index file. Once a user gives a query, the query should be done all the parsing techniques, then the parsed query should be given into the matching part. Matching will be done for both the user query and the document which is present on the information retrieval system. Once a matched document is found, it will be passed on to the ranking function, and the ranked documents will be shown as a result to the user interface. So these are the main important components that are helpful for constructing an architecture of an information retrieval system. Thank you.